back from Maestro Vito Iacovelli. Thank you so much for watching and taking the key and dedicating your time to watch my video. I'm so proud. Thank you so much. Today I'm going to show you something very, very special. I'm going to make are you ready? Today I'm going to show you how to make 100% Polish dough high hydration for the pizza alla pala. Yes, today I'm going to make show you how to make a pizza alla pala. Yes, vai Paolo. Abbiamo Paolo, si sta nascondendo.
Ciao.
He's hiding. He's laughing because he's watching me making this video. Paolo, sì, oggi facciamo la pizza alla pala come la fanno a Roma. Alta idratazione, Polish 100%.
Sono molto curioso di vedere cosa ne esce fuori. Sarà un lavoro speciale, tutto quello che fa Vito è così.
Bravi, stiamo lavorando in alcuni video insieme, in collaborazione, fantastici. Guys, we are working in some videos in collaboration that you're gonna be inspired. Yes, let's go see how to make this Polish 100%.
Andiamo.
Andiamo. Very simple to make this recipe. Polish is a pre-fermented dough made with just 5 grams of dry yeast. If you use a fresh yeast, go ahead and use 10 grams. Done. Then 1 liter of water, room temperature, and 1 kilo of flour. Now, simply, we go ahead and add the yeast. Mix it up, simply, and then let's go ahead and let's put the water, little by little. Voila. Voila, nicely done. Let's mix it up everything together. Woo! This Polish is made with type 1 flour. Ok amici, semplicemente, è facilissimo da fare questo Polish. 1 litro di acqua, 1 chilo di farina e 5 grammi di lievito secco. Se usate il lievito di birra andate a mettere 10 grammi. Mischiamo per bene, ecco qua. Wow! Fantastico. Ecco qua. There we go. Done. Mix up the Polish. And now let's go ahead and let's cover with a nice lid. Let's close it. Really, really good. Done. It's closed. Very easy to make. Now, pay attention. Pay attention. This Polish needs to go in the room temperature for 2 hours, then I'm going to put the Polish in the fridge for 24 hours. Il Polish, attenzione, 2 ore fuori dal frigorifero quando l'avete fatto e dopo andiamo a mettere il nostro Polish per 24 ore nel frigorifero e poi sarà pronto. Andiamo, let's go! Of course, I have the Polish already made. And here you go, how we find the Polish, done, nice, full of bubble, voila. Now, we're gonna go ahead and make 100% Polish dough with type 1. There, our Polish is ready after 24 hours in the fridge. I take it out and you just need to have 400 grams of flour. In this case, I'm using type 1, but you go ahead and use whatever you want. And we are going to do high hydration dough made with 100% Polish. 100%, that means that we are not going to add more water, only flour to get to the point of our dough. Amici, 100% di 100% impasto Polish vuol dire che noi andremo ad aggiungere soltanto 400 grammi di farina, quindi a completare il nostro preimpasto. Andiamo a vedere come farlo e andiamo a vedere il secondo step. Guys, let's go ahead and let's make the second step. And don't forget, in the flour, we're gonna go ahead and put 45 grams of salt. Let's mix it up and voila, the flour is ready. Simply go ahead and add the flour little by little. There we go. And mix it up with your right hand. Now that we have all the flour, let's start to work out the dough, just like that. Incorporate the flour in the dough. It's simple, it seems very hard, but it's very simple. It's very hydrated the dough. Make sure it's a little bit hard, but we are going to make it happen. We're gonna try to incorporate everything once it's in the box. Amici, ovviamente questo è un impasto ad alta idratazione, quindi lavoratelo per bene. Okay, there we go. The dough is almost ready. It's going to be really, really sticky. But don't worry about. At this point, let's get a little bit of flour. Let's put it down on the counter. There we go, not too much. And then let's go ahead and let's put the dough in the counter because we want to work the dough by hands now. Of course, if you're going to use the dough machine, of course, it's going to be much easier. So we want to work the dough about until it's really nice and gets gold together and strong. Dobbiamo impastare fino a che il nostro impasto è bello incordato. You get the mix really strong. Across, across, across. Voilà. Cross, cross. Now, to make the gluten a little bit more stronger, let's go ahead and let's wait about 15-20 minutes cover. Now that we have mixed up the dough, let's go ahead and let's let it rest for about 10 minutes, just like that, to be able to make the gluten a little bit stronger. You'll see in a little bit. Amici, 10 minuti. Lasciamo riposare con la plastica sopra. Questo riposo renderà l'impasto un po' più facile per essere incordato. The dough, 10 minutes passed by, have some little bit of olive oil on the side, and let's get also a container. Usually the same size, a little bit bigger than the dough. So let's put it on the side, and now I'm going to show you what to do next. Andiamo a vedere che cosa fare in questo momento. Ecco qua, fantastico. Salviamo la plastica, let's get a little bit of olive oil on your hands and then pay attention. Attenzione amici, un po' d'olio sulle mani e andiamo a staccare l'impasto da... Questi movimenti devono essere molto veloci. Ok, now let's get the dough and let's get more... If you see now, it's going to be more smooth the dough. Like you can see. There we go, see? That 10 minutes made the dough more strong. So a couple of more times, the goal here is to make the dough smooth. If it's not smooth, let's wait another 10 minutes. Done. You can see, let's get a little bit of olive oil on your hands, again. And then let's go ahead and let's form a big ball, just like that. Nice. Like you can see, is nicely smooth, so that means it's ready to go in the box. Get a container, a little bit of olive oil inside. Let's wipe it down with the olive oil. Un po' d'olio dentro al contenitore su tutti gli angoli, così l'impasto non si andrà a incollare. Now let's get the dough. Same way, let's form a big ball, and now let's go ahead and let's put in the container. Let's go ahead and let's close the dough and let it rest for 30 minutes. Close at room temperature. Riposiamo per 30 minuti a temperatura ambiente. I want to explain to you all this this step that we are doing. It's for a reason. Every time that we are going to let it rest and then mix it up again, let it rest and make the balls again, is to make the dough with full of air, more air inside. This is how they do the bread. So the more times that you do it, the more bubbles we are going to have. But pay attention, because to do that way, you have to have a high hydrated dough. I want to explain this a little bit in Italian. Wow, it's time to put a like. Amici, vi spiego un attimino per che cosa servono tutti questi passaggi di riposo e riformare la pallina. Perché più andiamo a fare questi step, più saranno le nostre bolle che troveremo, la nostra aria che troveremo dentro l'impasto, i cosiddetti alveoli. Quindi così fanno il pane, ecco perché viene impastato più volte, viene fatto riposare più volte e gli alveoli sono molto di più. Quindi questo impasto è fatto al 100% polish e alto di idratazione perché vogliamo fare una pizza più croccante e soffice nello stesso momento, quindi abbiamo bisogno di quegli alveoli enormi dentro l'impasto. Spero questa spiegazione vi sia stato d'aiuto. Okay, let's go ahead and let's do the third step. Voilà. Now, the goal here is to make the top of the dough nice and smooth. So, after this this second time that we let it rest, let's go ahead and let's take the dough out again from the box, just like that. Now, you'll notice that the dough is becoming more and more smooth. And automatically this one will make strong the gluten. Put a little bit of olive oil on the side, on your hands, and now, voila, our dough is ready to go in the box and rest. Ok amici, ecco qui. Dopo al terzo passaggio andiamo di nuovo a metterlo nel contenitore, perché ora a questo punto è pronto ed è liscio. Lasciamolo nel contenitore a temperatura ambiente fino a che raddoppia. Guys, so now we let it rest at room temperature until the dough doubles up. So it depends on the room temperature that you have, that usually takes 1 hour to 2 hours. Guys, now, dipende dalla temperatura ambiente che avete, ci vorranno dall'1 alle 2 ore. Andiamo and let's wait. Voilà. And here we go, how we find the dough after 1 hour. Double up the size. So now one more time, we go ahead and let's make the ball. This way, we're going to make the dough a little bit more strong and full of air. Like you can see, look at this. Nice and full of air. Ecco qua amici, abbiamo dato l'ultimo passo, dopodiché possiamo andare a fare le nostre palline per la pala. There we go. So now let's go ahead and let's put it back in the container. Just like that. Let's close it and let's wait about 10 minutes to 15 minutes. And, voilà guys, now it's ready to go ahead and make the balls. Let's go ahead and let's flip it over. Just gently. Wow, full of air. A little bit of flour on top in the container. And then let's go ahead and let's make, depends how big you want to make the ball, the pizza. In this case, actually, we're going to go ahead and let's make two, three balls. And let's make it happen. We want to create a ball, not like an actual ball, but we want to create like a loaf of dough. Wow. There we go. Make it smooth, make it nice, and put the loaf into it. Amici, ecco qua. Abbiamo formato il nostro panetto. Voilà. Andiamo e prendiamo l'ultima. Voilà. Done, guys. Now we're gonna let it rest until it doubles up a little bit and then they are ready to go ahead and make the pizza. Usually it takes about 40 minutes. Let's go ahead and let's close it. Done. At room temperature 40 minutes. 40 minuti, super good. And voila, after 40 minutes the dough is double up, so that means it's ready to rock and roll. So let's put the pay attention how I stretch this pizza. Attenzione come stendo questa pizza perché è molto importante. Andiamo e mettiamo un bel po' di farina di semola sotto. Andiamo e la prendiamo. Attenzione come prendete la pasta. Let's get our dough gently and we flip it over. Bam! The dough is going to be really soft and smooth. Then let's get the flour on top. And now we don't stretch, we just press with your finger. Just like that, because we want to keep the air inside the crust. Ecco qua, amici, dobbiamo soltanto premere con le dita in questo modo. Basta così. Ora andiamo a togliere tutta la farina. Let's get the crown, the flour. And let's make some space. In this case, I'm going to use a special peel, which is from G-Meta, it's made just for this pizza. And we go ahead and let's put it upside down in the peel. So now let's make the size that we want. The dough is really soft. Fantastic. There we go. Now that we have the size that we want, set up the oven at 400 Fahrenheit, 190 Celsius. Il forno deve essere pre-riscaldato a 190 gradi, ragazzi. Let's go ahead and let's put the tomato sauce. Io in questo caso ci metto la salsa sopra, dopo e la cuocio per 5 minuti. There we go, guys. Now, gently. There we go, guys. Now we are ready to go in the oven. Let's cook it at 400 Fahrenheit for 5 minutes. Let's close the oven. This dough is perfect for an electric oven hot at your house. This oven you can preheat as the temperature that you want. Amici, questa pizza è perfetta per farla a casa o ad un forno elettrico, perché ovviamente la temperatura è perfetta, se è possibile cuocerla alla bassa temperatura. Quindi abbiamo chiuso il forno perché ha bisogno della sua pressione. Cuociamo per 5 minuti. Let's cook it for just 5 minutes and then after we are going to put the ingredients. Here we go, guys. 5 minutes passed by. 5 minuti sono passati. La nostra pizza è pronta. La prima fase è pronta. Voilà. Nice and puffy. Wow. Wow. Let me show you closely the crunchiest of this dough. Now we are going to put the ingredients. Wow, it's empty. Can't wait to put all the ingredients. In this case, we're going to add some fresh mozzarella and making the classic cheese margherita pizza, Napoletana style. But you can use anything that you want, all the ingredients. Actually, if you make some specialty pizza, it will look something really fantastic. Wow! Oh, I almost forgot. A little bit of Parmesan cheese. Voila! Now we can go ahead and finish to cook the pizza. And the pizza almost ready. Fantastic, Ashley is ready. Pronta, amici. Wow. Wow. Molto calda. Fantastic, pronta! Wow! Crunchy! Fantastic! Wow! So now we're gonna go ahead and finish it with a little bit of fresh basil. Fantastic pizza! Amen! Now it's time to go ahead and put a like. And now, of course, we're gonna go ahead and see the inside and the tasting part. I mean, listen to this. Listen to this crunchy. Wow. Let's cut and show you the inside. Wow. It's soft and crunchy. The outside, it's amazing. The pizza came out outstanding, amazing. Take a look. Let me come on. Show you closely the pizza, how it come out outstanding, crunchy, soft in the same time. Type one. Wow. Wow and wow. I mean, now it's time to go ahead and comment. Take a look. Wow, amici, c'è. Now is the time, but today I'm gonna taste it with my friend Paolo Palmieri. Paolo, vieni qua, non ti nasconde dietro il basilico, abbassati.
Ciao.
Abbassati, abbassati.
It looks great.
Wow, it looks great. What about the tasting? Take a look.
Io mangio.
Ma è che cominci sempre senza di me, cioè comincia sempre senza di me, non è giusto, Paolo.
Pizza is my favorite food.
Mm. Very bon. Very, very fragrant. Wow.
Dai, taglialo pezzo.
Arriva, arriva, come Antonio, arriva.
Solo. No, dammi un pezzo centrale. Dammi, passami quella forbice, va. Visto che questo qua si taglia la forbice, la pizza. Ma come cazzo, la taglia qua la forbice.
Fate l'amore con il sapore. Ciao.